It's the modern carbonara, better than the classic carbonara. Why modern chefs tell you to use only the egg yolks when the classic use the entire eggs? Let's have a look and see which one is best. And welcome to Vincenzo's Plate, the place where you get to learn how to cook easy, simple, homemade Italian recipes. Today we are making a modern carbonara. It doesn't mean that I'm making a Gordon Ramsay carbonara. No. I'm not adding any new ingredients. I'm making a carbonara with the same ingredients, but we are using egg yolks and not the entire egg, because modern chefs in Rome like to use only the egg yolks, okay? The traditional doesn't use the egg yolks, everything. Let's make it. Let's see if it makes any difference. Who's gonna be the winner? You guys tell me. Can I be honest with you? I love carbonara. Egg yolks, entire egg for me, are both delicious. But let's see who's the winner. To make the perfect modern carbonara, we need simple but perfect and delicious ingredients. Now, the most important ingredient is the guanciale. It is very hard to find, so you can replace it with pancetta. You have to find pancetta everywhere. So as you can see, the guanciale has a lot of fat, okay? Here we have, you know, the herbs on top. We have this pepper, there's garlic in there. So there are flavors in this guanciale. You know, it's been cured, usually cured for a couple of months, okay? Spaghetti pasta. Now, the classic spaghetti alla carbonara uses spaghetti. If you want to use a different pasta, you can use linguine, you can use short pasta like penne, you can use rigatoni, mezze maniche, anything that you like. The ingredient that is going to make the cream, the eggs. We have 3 eggs because I'm using 300 grams of pasta. So every 100 gram of pasta, I use 1 egg. So 300 grams of pasta, 3 eggs. And last but not least, this is pecorino cheese. I have kilos and kilos and kilos of pecorino cheese in my house. I love pecorino, my favorite cheese, and I put it everywhere. You wanna mix pecorino and parmigiano? I know lots of you like to do that. Okay, do it. The very first thing I want to do is to cut the guanciale, okay? So this is like a 300 grams piece of guanciale, which is too much for 300 grams of pasta. I say use about 70 grams of guanciale for every 100 grams of pasta, okay? So here we remove the skin. The skin is something that we don't want to use for carbonara. Now the carbonara, see, it's got lots of fat. What we're going to do is I like to cut it into strips. And when I say strips, I mean strips. So what we do is we cut this. Okay, we have a slice. And then here, we cut the strips, just like that. The strip has the meat, the fat, and the meat again, okay? Actually, now that cut this, I can actually tell you, it is a nice guanciale, I have to say. This guanciale is not the one from Rome, it's made here in Australia, it's not bad. It actually looks pretty good. I've been cutting it, and the inside, you can see we have enough meat, enough fat, and it's gonna be fantastic for our carbonara because the fat will melt and the meat will become nice and moist. What's guanciale? Guanciale is the big chick. So the flavors are very different to the pancetta. Okay, right now we're going to cook the guanciale on a pan without oil, gently on a medium-low heat, okay? We don't want to burn the guanciale. We don't want to stress the guanciale. What we want for the guanciale is very simple. We want the fat to create the oil that we need. So we gently want to cook the guanciale. We want to get it crispy and crunchy on the outside, but moist on the inside. Now look at the oil that we have created over here. See this? This oil is created by the fat of the guanciale. That oil, it's full of flavors. And that's the importance of the guanciale. If you don't have the guanciale, you don't get those flavors, my friend. You don't get this oil. The flavors are really coming out. The kitchen smells like guanciale. The guanciale is ready. So what we do is we start cooking the pasta. Now, usually when I boil my pasta, I use a large pot. Like now, I'm using a large pot and a lot of water. For carbonara, cacio e pepe, you know, we don't want to use a lot of water. We need the water to be full of starch. So I'm using half of this pot full of water, and I'm adding half tablespoon of salt. The reason why I do that is because we need to use the pasta water for a sauce, so I don't want this to be too salty. When I reacted to Alex the Cooking Guy cacio e pepe video, he made me realize how important it is not to put too much salt into your water, and I've done it all my life. So thanks to Alex, I realized I'm gonna put less salt in the pasta water, because I'm gonna use the pasta water in the eggs mix to create the cream. And also I'm using pecorino cheese in the cream. So I don't want this to be extremely salty. So thank you, Alex. As you can see, the water is boiling, which means it is ready to cook your pasta. So what we're doing right now is we put the spaghetti in there, and we read the instruction on the packet. This spaghetti needs 11 minutes to cook. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take them out at 10 minutes, 1 minute less that it should cook, okay? The last minute of cooking, we do it in the pan. The water is boiling, the guanciale is ready. What do we do now? We make the cream for the carbonara, made with eggs. So what we need to do is we need to separate the yolks and the white. So here I use an empty one. So here we use one to collect the yolks, which, you know, you can make meringue, you can make amaretti, but if you don't want to do anything, this is going to be a waste. I'm sorry. That's one of the reasons why I don't like this modern carbonara. So here again, we get the yolk. Perfect. Here we only have the egg yolks, okay? See that? We've got the egg yolks. And what we do is we get the bag, the important bag. And what I'm going to do is for 3 egg yolks, I'm going to use 6 tablespoons of pecorino, double the amount. Yes, I'm going to be very generous with the pecorino, because pecorino is everything for this dish. You do need it. So here we go. We mix it, just mix it. We want to get a paste made with the pecorino and the eggs. See how dense it is? I want the pecorino to actually melt, disappear in the eggs. That's what we want to achieve. We want to get a nice dark yellow, almost orange mix, you know, that's what we want to get. Okay guys, the pasta is ready. Before we get the pasta out, you get a nice mug full of pasta water. The pasta water is extremely important to combine all the ingredients, okay, to get a creamy, creamy pasta. Now we're gonna take the pasta out, okay, and we put it in the pan together with the guanciale. So we just want to get the pasta out, put it in there. And what we want to do right now, straight away, you add 1/2 mug of pasta water. Perfect. We're going to keep cooking the pasta in the pan. So what we do now, I used 1/2 mug of water, because we need to do the cooking of the pasta in the pan, called risottatura. It's like when you make rice. So you need to keep stirring your pasta in there. It's got the water in there. Now, as you can see, the water is kind of disappearing. There's not much water left in there. Okay, not much at all. But we do need a little bit of water before we add the egg. So let's put a little bit more, because we want the water at the bottom. So when we put the egg inside, we are not getting the scrambled eggs. Time now to switch off the stove. Gas is off. And now is the moment where we're adding the cream, okay? So as you can see, this is very, very dark. So this carbonara must be very, very creamy. We need to mix now this cream with the pasta, okay? So we want the eggs to melt in this mix. Look how creamy this is becoming. It does look like it's creamier, yes. It looks like it's less runny. It looks like it needs to be eaten straight away. Any scrambles? No scrambles, no. Even though the original carbonara requires a sort of scrambles in there. Did I forget something? Yes, I forgot to put the pepper in the mix. Can I fix this? Yes, you can add the pepper at the end. Nice, must be freshly done on the spot. Is this gonna be okay? Yes, it should be okay. Put as much as you can, because carbonara means charcoal. It was created in the mining, so basically should be covered with pepper. Look how much pepper we want in there. A little bit more mix, and now we serve. Let's plate this carbonara with love, okay? So put it on a white plate so I can see the difference of the classic carbonara. Does it look different in color? No, but I want to blame the eggs here, because the egg yolk should have made this a little bit darker, which is not darker. It is definitely creamier than the classic carbonara make. So the only thing we can do is to try. We have to test it. We have to see how this tastes before we can say if it's good or not. Let's try. Look, I am a carbonara lover. I can't really tell you the difference between this and the other one, you know, because both of them are delicious. I don't want to judge it. I don't want to say better than the other. I can say that this is a little bit creamier. It doesn't mean it's better, okay? The discussion of the day is egg yolks or entire egg. That's the only discussion we should have from 2020 for the next thousands of years. There is no cream involved, and definitely no peas. Yeah. Please, guys, leave a like and tell us in the comment below what version do you prefer? Egg yolk, entire egg, Gordon Ramsay carbonara, what do you prefer? Tell us, please, we want to know. So thank you so much. E ora si mangia. Vincenzo's plate.